One of the issues on the Eau Claire County ballot next month is the state minimum wage. Wisconsin's minimum wage is $7.25 an hour. For someone working full-time, 40 hours a week, that comes out to a little over $15,000 a year. Now, a complaint was filed under our living wage law recently, claiming that $7.25 is not enough to live on, and as you know, the Department of Workforce Development rejected that. Well, please tell us if you believe a Wisconsin worker can live on our minimum wage, if you believe the state has any obligation to make sure workers are paid some sort of minimum wage, and if so, what that minimum wage should be. Ms. Burke, we'll start with you.
I don't think that our minimum wage is enough for folks to live on, and that's why I strongly support an increase in the minimum wage to the suggested $10.10 an hour over three steps. I talk to business people about this, both small business owners and large business owners, and they support increasing this. And the reason is first of all, it reduces reliance on government assistance. I want people who work full-time to be able to have that pride of a job, of being able to support themselves. And at $7.25 an hour, that's just ridiculous. You can't do that. It ensures that people are dependent on government assistance. The second reason to do it is this is additional money that gets spent right back into our economy, which helps local small businesses and our communities grow. Business person Craig Culver, great homegrown Culver's restaurants, I think we all are very proud of that. He supports increasing that minimum wage for working adults. That is the smart thing to do. It's going to help our economy and it's going to reduce government assistance.
Governor Walker?
Well, back in August, I met a wonderful 25-year-old woman who was at WCTC for her first time going back to school to be a welder. The way to do that is
Governor
get people
Walker,
the skills they need to go forward.
Ms. Burke?
Well, the fact is Governor Walker actually made cuts to our technical college system, taking them back in his first budget to 1989 funding levels. So now to just put additional money into grants now don't help the 41,000 people who are on the financial aid wait list while giving tax breaks to those at the top. Also, it's unrealistic to think that all of the workers that work in retail, home health care, that are paid the minimum wage are going to be able to shift to welding jobs. That's just not realistic. There aren't that many jobs out there. We have got to raise the minimum wage immediately.
Governor Walker?
There's a website the state has called jobcenterwisconsin.com. Right now, this week, there's over 70,000 job openings on that. We don't have a jobs problem in the state. We have a work problem. We've got to connect the dots between people looking for a job or looking for a better job and the skills they need to fill those jobs. And it's not just in welding.
Keith, I believe you asked a specific question about the actual minimum wage.
I did. Governor Walker, I need you to answer. Do you believe a Wisconsin worker can live on our minimum wage? Do you believe the state has an obligation to make sure workers are paid some sort of minimum wage, and if so, what that should be? I need an answer.
Yeah, and my point is I believe the state should be focused on helping people create jobs that are much greater than the minimum wage. The way you do that is by ultimately giving people the skills that they need, opening
Time
up the
up.
Programs. And as far as the technical colleges go, the reality is we saved the technical colleges, our schools,
Governor
our local
Walker,
governments
time is
more
up.
Than $3 billion, and that's money they used to.
Ms. Burke? Ms. Burke, your rebuttal.
I had actually already rebutted to the minimum wage.
When we ask the follow-up question, we give each person a chance to respond. So
yes,
so
no, I don't. I don't believe that people can support themselves on the minimum wage, and that's why I strongly support increasing that minimum wage. It's money that will get spent back in our local economies, and it's what's going to help create actually more jobs. But I want to be clear about this. As governor, I want to reduce people's need for public assistance. And that's what the minimum wage does.
Thank you.